I truly appreciate the opportunity. And as they say, all good things must come to an end.
Good evening, and welcome to Farewell to Favre, a look back at the legendary career of Brett Lorenzo Favre. I'm NBC 15 Sports Director Rob Vogel. Over the next hour, we'll take you from Golden Brett's days at Southern Mississippi to his arrival in Green Bay and relive the ride that number four took Packers fans on for 16 glorious seasons in Titletown. One that sadly ended on the field with this final pass that was intercepted in the NFC Championship game in overtime by the Giants, dashing hopes of one last trip to the Super Bowl. Tonight we'll also hear from Favre in his own words describe what it was like being the driver of one of the greatest thrill rides pro football has ever seen, and what he hopes will be the lasting legacy of the journey that is destined to end 5 years from now with enshrinement in Canton, Ohio. But first, we kick off this show with a look at the week that no one who bleeds green and gold will ever forget. His retirement was inevitable. Still, the when and why Favre left a phone message on Tuesday that turned the football world upside down are questions that only Wisconsin's favorite adopted son can answer.
This is NBC 15 News.
It is the end of an unforgettable career.
It is the story everyone is talking
about.
The
day that all Packer fans have been dreading.
Brett Favre has decided to retire.
Brett Favre is retiring.
Or left a voicemail for ESPN's Chris Mortensen saying,
you know, mentally I'm tired. Physically I feel okay. Stress. I mean, studying every week, preparing, and the more we won, the more stressful it got, which you would think otherwise, but I mean, it was a challenge I guess I wasn't up for. I know I can play. That was really it. That's what it came down to.
As you're all well aware of by now, Brett has informed us of his decision to retire.
The entire football world is going to miss seeing this guy play football.
He's had one of the greatest careers in the history of the National Football League.
Just a great player, and this is why they've been so good, because of his, you know, work ethic.
Brett's accomplishments are legendary, but it was the passion with which he played that has made everyone a Brett Favre fan.
Great players come and go, and new great players come in and replace them. I think he'll be a tough one to replace.
I think we're all a little bit disappointed, but at the same time, we respect Brett's decision.
Without a doubt, that had they signed Randy Moss, that Brett Favre would have gone back. But I don't think that was the final domino. But I think had that happened, yes, I think Brett would have gone back.
I can't speak to that. It was never brought up in any of my conversations with Brett, and I don't think with Mike either.
Never one time in all the conversations we've had since the season ended did any player acquisition come up as a topic. I mean, I think what's happened here is, like Ted said, these are separate topics. This was a personal decision.
I know there's been comments and issues in the press lately about why I'm leaving, whether or not the Packers did enough, whether or not Ted and Mike tried to convince me to stay. None of those things have anything to do with me retiring. And that's from the heart. I've given everything I possibly can give to this organization, to the game of football, and I don't think I got anything left to give, and that's it. I know I can play, but I don't think I want to.
That's what happened this week. But as everyone knows, one cell phone message and one press conference is not what will be the lasting legacy of Brett Favre's Hall of Fame to be career. And that's what tonight's show will be devoted to. Up next, we'll dust off the old tapes and look back at the birth of a legend, follow his rise all the way to the day the kid from Kill returned the Lombardi Trophy to Titletown. Take an in-depth look at how Favre's impact on Packer Nation extends far beyond the field. And make sure to crank up the VCRs or DVRs for our special musical tribute to a career unlike any other. Our first break gives you a chance to take part in this show by choosing your favorite Brett Favre memory, five of which we'll play for you throughout this show. Log on to our web channel, NBC15.com, to cast your vote. The results will be revealed tomorrow night on Wisconsin Sports Sunday. Play number one turns back the clock, the Packers' final game in County Stadium, a leap of faith that would vault the Packers into the postseason and left its mark on Ted Thompson.
1994, against the Atlanta Falcons in Milwaukee County Stadium.
Move the kicker! throw.
When he takes off running, we have no timeouts left.
Brett Favre!
And if he gets tackled, we're going to lose the game. He dives in the end zone and makes it.
Down, Green Bay!
This is a thing of beauty. This is a thing that Bart Starr would have been proud of. This is a thing that Vince Lombardi dreamed of, a player like Brett Favre.
I don't know if that's not just a little snapshot I want to hang on to and remember that.
What a way to leave Milwaukee.
For you, it's not just mowing the lawn. It's about owning a John Deere from Sloan's. Easy Track. So easy to handle, it almost drives itself. Check out any John Deere today at one of Sloan's five Wisconsin locations.
Anchor floor to ceiling. Quality wall to wall. Top to bottom, through and through. In everything they do. Anchor makes interiors. The kind you'll be proud to call yours. Anchor floor to ceiling. Quality wall to wall.
Located near Star Cinema in Fitchburg.
There's a new mutt in town, and he's about to spot his territory. You've been warned. Lazy Mutt Farmhouse Ale is a craft brewed wheat-style beer made in small batches in Monroe, Wisconsin. Lazy Mutt, man's best friend.
If ever you're not satisfied with one of our tires, please feel free to bring it back. Thank you. Discount Tire Company.
Satisfaction is having every customer walk out of our door with a smile on their face. That's total satisfaction.
Our company is built on integrity, so if we walk out to a customer's car and they don't need tires, we'll be happy to let them know they don't need tires and hope that they come back when they do. Come on in for a great deal on Michelin tires. I'll take care of you.
It's tournament time, and everyone's a winner at Sloan Implement. With tight turns and faster speeds, the easy track is nothing but net. March into Sloan Implement and test drive your new John Deere before you buy.
As I look back in my career and as I watched footage last night and things, I have come a long ways in a positive way. And I'm truly thankful for that.
Welcome back to Farewell to Favre, NBC 15's look at Brett Favre's second-to-none career. Now, if you had told anyone at the 1991 NFL Draft that the Southern Mississippi Golden Eagle would go on to become one of the best and most beloved quarterbacks in the history of the game, let alone doing it as a Packer, you'd probably have been suited for a straitjacket. And while the road to Canton did start with a few bumps in the road, it eventually paved a way to return the Packers to their championship glory.
The birth of the legend has a life of its own. The seeds were sown deep in the heart of Mississippi. A football coach and father, whose roots were in the running game, passed on the love of that game to his gifted son, who used that tutelage and turned it into something special. The world's first chance to see football's future came at Southern Mississippi. A school that was far from a football factory had recruited him as a safety, but produced the first glimpses of the brilliance that was in store for all to witness.
I think I got the good arm, and I think if they give me a shot, I think I can do it for them.
And he did do it, earning himself a second-round draft selection by the Atlanta Falcons in 1991, a seemingly perfect football marriage of a run-and-shoot team and a raw talent who did the same. After only one forgettable season, Favre was traded for a first-round pick to a franchise searching for a player of the future that could return the Packers to its past glory.
You know, at first I was a little shocked and thought that, you know, they're going to send me up there to be a backup in Green Bay. But, you know, after talking to the owner and the head coach there today, they want me to come in and start. And it's up to me on whether or not, you know, I become the starter. So, hey, you know, I can't ask for more.
It took only three games into the 1992 season for the legend to begin writing his story. Starter Don Majkowski left the game with an injury, and like Lou Gehrig replacing Wally Pipp, the NFL's version of the Iron Horse never looked back, throwing the winning touchdown on a laser to Kittrick Taylor with 16 seconds left. 16 football falls later, Favre had answered the bell in every game the Packers played. It's hard to imagine now, but looking back, there were moments when Favre's career was in doubt.
Got pressure on him.
Mike Holmgren, charged with taming his wild stallion quarterback, nearly benched Favre several times.
Here's Favre.
But true greatness often takes time.
Touchdown! He's in the record books.
And in 1995, Favre came into his own, lifting the Packers into the ranks of the NFL's elite. That year, on the strength of 38 touchdown passes, Favre won the first of what would be a record 3 consecutive Most Valuable Player awards.
Favre rolls one way and trouble the other. Touchdown, Brooks! If Brett Favre isn't the NFL's MVP this season, there ought to be an investigation.
When asked about his trophy that season, Favre made some bold predictions.
I felt like I'd earned, you know, at least a chance to win it. But then to win it that overwhelming was great. My personality is that I believe I can win the MVP. I believe I can be the quarterback in the Super Bowl. I believe, you know, I can be the Super Bowl MVP in the Hall of Fame one day. You know, I believe all those things. And I think if I didn't, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
Touchdown. What followed was the fruits of that labor of love that began as a boy with his father, Irv, many years before.
Favre. Touchdown, Favre. Being chased by DeMarco, Favre got away, throws, touchdown!
Going deep. Holy moly, that! Antonio Freeman.
A career-high 39 touchdowns in a 13-3 96 season. One in which the Packers finally got over the hump, returning to Super Sunday.
The dance in, and Favre got settled down in a hurry.
This is one of the reasons I vote for Brett Favre for MVP. Look, he hands off, and then he goes back and he fakes that jump pass. Now, no one has thrown a jump pass since Sid Luckman. Greatest moment of your life. You'll never forget it. They could never take it away.
I've accomplished a lot. This team has accomplished a lot. We did it together. But I have to tell you, winning the Super Bowl feels much better than winning the MVP.
For an encore, Favre picked up right where he left off.
Guns it to the end zone on third down and 3. And Brett Favre tries to escape, and the pass is caught.
Another 13-win MVP season.
Looking downfield, 6 points, and his pass is caught.
Meant another trip to the Super Bowl, where his career would intersect with the man who first made Favre's gunslinger style famous. And despite outplaying Denver's John Elway, it was the Broncos who rode their Hall of Famer to the upset victory.
John Mobley broke it up.
Dashing the Packers' shot at going down as one of the NFL's greatest teams. From that point forward, Favre's career turned to a new chapter, one in which, as coaches and teammates came and went, he continued the pursuit of one more run to the big show.
Hard to believe that would be the last Super Bowl Favre would play in. In fact, it wasn't until this past season, his last, that Favre would again reach the NFC Championship game. As we head to another break, it was a Super Sunday that produced great moment number 2 on our top 5. Call it opening with an audible and a bang on the bayou.
People have asked me, you know, what's my favorite moment of Brett Favre's career? And I really think it was the first touchdown in Super Bowl 31.
Bennett, the lone setback. Two tight ends set up for the Packers, and Favre back to throw his first one.
And he threw to Rison.
Has a man open. Andre Rison does the dance.
He ran off the field with his helmet off.
Favre got settled down in a hurry.
That is a way to settle down.
He looked like a kid running home to mom with his first great report card.
Discover a refuge in your own backyard. The knowledgeable staff at Wild Birds Unlimited will show you a selection of gifts, garden accents, and unique products that will help you enjoy nature every day. Wild Birds Unlimited on Old Sauk Road in Middleton. We bring people and nature together.
The right ones with the good stuff. Come and stop.
Introducing the New Holland line of tractors at Carl F. Stotts & Sons. New Holland compact four-wheel drive tractors. New Holland boomer tractors and utility tractors. And the T7000 series. Choose from 11 models and a wide array of implements for mowing, landscaping, and material handling. See the complete line of New Holland at Carl F. Stotts & Sons, Highway 19, Wanakee.
Trust your landscape project to a Barnes professional. With over 25 years as Madison's choice for landscape design, installation, and maintenance, you can rest assured that Barnes can tackle any job, large or small, to create an oasis that will delight and you'll enjoy year after year. Whether you're looking to give your existing landscape some TLC, or if you'd like to create a whole new look, Barnes is the only name you need to know. We'll show you just how relaxing enjoying your new landscape can be.
These are a few of the fine neurosurgeons, neuroradiologists, pain management physicians, and other specialists who lead the way in providing coordinated care and cutting-edge technology. These minds work together to provide innovative approaches to individuals with back and neck pain, brain and spinal tumors, and traumatic brain and spine injuries. The Mercy Health System Institute of Neuroscience. Exceptional quality, extraordinary care.
Dazzle, a new surprise for your eyes around every corner. Dazzle, a huge selection of designer-inspired jewelry, handbags, and accessories just for you. Dazzle, high fashion, low prices, 8426 Old Sauk Road, Madison.
Statistics never really a big part of my makeup, but, and I think people know that. I'm well aware of this. The statistics and records that I have right now, I think those are meant to be, that's why they keep records, because they're meant to be broken. I hope my legacy is a lot more than that.
It's an interesting contradiction. Brett Favre leaves the game the owner of the most significant records a quarterback can attain. And yet, no signal caller's career is defined less by numbers. Our David Kamisik crunched the digits and joins us with more on just how Favre's stats are a fraction of the bottom line that fills up the record books.
Yeah, Rob, 2007 was obviously a memorable season for number four, partly because of the Packers' success as a team, but also because Favre shattered passing records along the way, further cementing his status as one of the greatest in NFL history.
From the beginning of the legend...
19 seconds left.
Well, each time we have them, you know, I say this is the best one, and this is the best one.
To the one that put him atop the record books.
He's got it! There it is! The record!
I've never considered myself as good a quarterback as Dan Marino. To be mentioned in the same breath as Dan and other guys is quite an honor. I mean, that, to me, that's more important than the actual record itself.
A single season high 39 during his 1996 MVP season.
Antonio Freeman.
57 to Antonio Freeman.
Antonio Freeman, not overly talented, but always was open, always made plays.
Did he make the catch at the 15? Yes. What are they going to rule it? He caught it? Touchdown! He did what?
One that, though it doesn't count, will forever be etched in the minds of Packer fans.
Andre Rison does the dance in, and Favre got settled down in a hurry.
There have been short ones and long ones.
Going deep, man open at the 30. It's Robert Brooks.
Goodbye.
And Robert Brooks is inside the 30 and going all the way in for a touchdown.
Ones that were, well, let's just say a little bit unorthodox. Ones that have come with a throbbing thumb.
At one point, I almost came out. I'm so drained right now.
Sorry, fellas.
And ones that have come with a heavy heart, seemingly transcending the sport.
I didn't expect this type of performance, but I know he was watching tonight.
And we all watched the 28 this past season, as Favre proved the doubters wrong, showing he could still sling it with the best.
else would you want on center stage in a circumstance like that? And in one play, boom, ball game.
Never imagining that this four-yard pass to Bubba Franks would be the 442nd and final one of his career.
Just enjoys his time on the field.
So for now, number four is number one. And while his hold on history may only be temporary, his grasp on greatness will be forever.
Every touchdown phone has been a lot of fun.
And we've had fun watching each one. The NFL record, 288 interceptions, on the other hand, we could live without, but let's not get picky. Favre also the NFL all-time leader in yards, completions, pass attempts, win as a quarterback, and 3,000-plus yard seasons. But let's not forget what many consider to be number four's greatest feat.
First-round draft choice to the Atlanta Falcons to get Brett Favre.
The streak. Its name is simple. Its accomplishment is anything but. Even Favre himself admits of all the milestones reached in his legendary career, he's most proud of the 253 consecutive starts.
The thing that I'm most impressed about in my career is the fact that I've played in all those games, whether it be consecutive or not. The fact that I've played in that many games is, to me, is amazing.
Favre's presence under center became a constant in Titletown. While other teams were stuck riding the quarterback merry-go-round, Packer fans always felt a sense of hope because number four was taking the snaps.
From Southern Mississippi, number four, Brett Favre!
Favre celebrated start number 200 with a memorable performance, throwing for three touchdowns in a Monday night romp of the Rams.
And Favre gets up limping.
But along the ride, there were plenty of bumps and bruises, coughing up blood, sprained and broken thumbs.
He's out there playing with a broken thumb, and he's still throwing spirals and still throwing touchdowns and still getting it done. So pretty hard to imagine being able to do that.
Foot sprains, knee injuries, concussions, an elbow nerve injury. But through it all, number four defined his status as an Ironman, as he was able to stand up, dust himself off, and overcome the pain time and time again, never backing down from any challenge.
He's not scared of anything, of anybody. You know, he would get in, up in some to somebody's first face and talk to him.
Not missing a single start in his 16 seasons with the green and gold.
He played the toughest position, the most demanding position. And you'd see him in the locker room after a game where he could hardly move, or you'd see him during the week in the locker room where he could hardly move. And on Sunday, he'd run out of the tunnel because he was ready to go. He was ready to compete. It was time to play.
And play he did.
Right there is why you love Brett Favre, that little kid enthusiasm.
Throwing snowballs.
I think he plays the game like you would if you were in a backyard and you were wearing Wrangler jeans.
Sprinting downfield to carry receivers.
Is that a guy that's been in the league 16 years?
High-fiving refs.
Here's one of the great things about Favre. He just enjoys his time on the field.
A grown man playing with the enthusiasm and free spirit of a young boy.
It's a game. I played it. It was spontaneous. Nothing was ever choreographed.
Dead to rights right here. Who has the presence to do that? I mean, where do you get that?
The spontaneity, the records, the streak, the playfulness. They will all go down as important pieces to the legacy of Brett Favre.
I don't think there's any doubt but that he will go down as the greatest player in the history of this wonderful organization.
And the guys that played with him, I think it's just going to be a part of their legacy when, you know, this guy gets into the Hall of Fame. Guys will be able to sit back at home and say, I played with one of the greatest quarterbacks in the National Football League.
The way he could affect people, the way he can walk into a room, the effect he had on the room.
He's a Mount Rushmore guy. He's one of our guys in the NFL that transcends decades and generations.
I hope people appreciate me the way I approached the game, the way I played it. To me, all was important. I'm well aware of the statistics and records that I have right now. I hope my legacy is a lot more than that.
Now, to put that streak in perspective, 212 different quarterbacks have started an NFL game since Favre's first start on September 27th, 1992. The Bears themselves, 21 different signal callers. Certainly a remarkable statistic. Also remarkable is our third nominee for Brett's most memorable moment, one that was inspired out of personal tragedy. In 2003, less than 24 hours after his father and mentor Irv passed away, Favre grieved in Oakland on national television by putting on a show that would make his dad proud while leaving the rest of us in stunned silence.
I knew my dad would want me to play.
The most difficult start of Brett Favre's illustrious career.
You couldn't draw up a script better than it was drawn up today.
And Favre throws six for six, and Favre going deep. It is caught. Touchdown into double coverage. Touchdown to Javon Walker.
I can't believe he went out and did what he did today. I mean, it was so heroic. In 10, 20 years, I don't know if I'll ever see somebody like that again.
I didn't expect this type of performance, but I know he was watching tonight.
Best part about working with Cleary was the representative.
They want what's best for you. They don't want to just sell a building. They want a building that's going to last for a long time.
Others are going to want to use Cleary because of their fantastic customer support, their prompt attention to detail.
Their structures, their laminated beams, and everything they do is just... it's built like a bunker, and that's the way I like to build things.
It really was a no-brainer to go with Cleary.
Cleary built with pride before the Shamrock Supplied.
If you and your significant other suffer from snoring and or sleep apnea and are annoyed by your CPAP machine, the TMJ and Sleep Center can provide alternative answers to your sleep concerns.
A new intraoral appliance worn while you sleep is available at the TMJ and Sleep Center. It can silently alleviate sleep apnea and the interruption in your lifestyle. Visit our website or call the TMJ and Sleep Center at 833-0865 to schedule a 15-minute complimentary consultation and kick the CPAP machine out of your bedroom for good.
Inspirational new flooring is here at Coil Carpet One, your Shaw Anso Nylon Premier dealer. You can be confident in the exceptional beauty and performance of Shaw Anso Nylon Carpets. Our extensive gallery features the styling, color, and texture that will excite your senses. And our styles all come with extended warranties. Receive free pad with the purchase of any Anso Nylon Carpet. And we'll even remove your existing carpet and pad for no additional charge. Plus, make no payments for 1 year. Shop today at Coil Carpet One Floor and Home, Rimrock Road at the Beltline.
It was just very, very nice, the military service for Dad. And it was just great. You come around the corner and you see all these military personnel all lined up. And then they did their 21-gun salute and folded the flag and handed the flag to me.
Our family is here for your family. For nearly 140 years, Crest Funeral and Cremation Service.
Being that we're in the public eye, things we've had to deal with, tragedy, obviously is dealt with within the community and the world.
Welcome back to the show. Sometimes it's hard to remember that athletic heroes are human, but with Favre, we were reminded of that fact time and time again. And his human frailties, as much as his trophies and his accomplishments as a player, is what turned a simple country kid into a member of all of our families. A loved one you wanted to stand by in good times and in bad.
Triumph.
Touchdown, Green Bay.
And tragedy.
I don't wish it upon anyone.
Both were in abundant supply during Brett Favre's career. In 1996, just 4 months after being dealt a blow on the field in the NFC Championship game at Dallas, the superstar's pain off it was revealed to the world.
The best thing to do was to get some help.
An addiction to the painkiller Vicodin gave everyone a glimpse at the man behind the curtain and served as a precursor to more bumps in the road for Favre.
Watch the back of his head.
Meanwhile,
he and his family were dealt many a bad hand, like his father's death in 2003.
I knew my dad would want me to play, and you know, I love him so much and love this game. It's meant a great deal to me, to my dad, and to my family.
To the passing of his brother-in-law 10 months later. In 2004, wife Deanna was diagnosed with breast cancer.
It's a shock at first. And once you get over that, then you go on from there. You deal with it and treat it the best way possible and hope for the best. Professional athletes are not immune to tragic circumstances and cancer. This just goes to show that we're no different than anyone else.
And even natural disasters, such as Hurricane Katrina, washing away much of the Gulf Coast region, including his hometown of Kill.
It's just sad, it really is. I try to remind myself of the things to be thankful for.
Through it all, there remained one constant. Like the player on the field, the man demonstrated an ability to pick himself up and keep moving forward.
I've never found myself saying, why me or why us? It takes too much time and it doesn't matter anyway.
To see him grow as a person and as a quarterback, yeah, I'm very proud of him.
Favre turned that gratitude into an attitude, which gave back to those he inspired. His Forward Foundation used events such as an annual softball game to raise money for children in Wisconsin.
Sure.
And when it came to one-on-one contact, such as his frequent visits to hospitals.
How many touchdowns did you get?
26, I think, this year, 27.
Or work with the Make-A-Wish Foundation, Favre proved again to have the golden touch.
Kind of puts things in perspective when you're able to do something like this and you realize that football is important, but not the most important thing.
Inspiring those around him, including 9-year-old Anna Walentowski, suffering from a rare brain disease.
It's difficult. I think we can appreciate what the family has had to go through. And I don't think I've ever seen Anna without a smile on her face.
It was this side of Packer Nation's football hero that, as much as his flair on the field, turned Brett Favre into a feeling, a thought, a way of life that lifted all who followed him to greater heights.
Throughout that process, I've become a better person. I'm probably as proud of that as anything I've done on the field. I have come a long ways in a positive way. I'm truly thankful for that.
From the emotional to the bizarre, that's the way to describe our top play nominee number 4, which you can vote for on our web channel, NBC15.com. More Monday Night Magic in overtime on a rainy November evening that left everyone saying, he did what?
It is heads.
Let's feel lucky.
Green Bay,
there.
You get the choice.
Favre lays it up for Freeman, and it's incomplete. He make the catch at the 15?
Yes.
What are they going to rule it? He caught it? Touchdown. He did what?
Ref was right on it, I think.
This is the main church building.
Here is the steeple.
And this is the location we have planned for the steeple.
Open the door.
And these are the entry doors we would like you to consider.
And see all the people.
At Roberts Construction, we will complete your project within budget and in many cases under budget and refund you the difference. We are building our 100th church and would like to add yours to our family album. Ask around and you'll know why Roberts Construction is the most trusted partner you can have on your next project.
When it comes to beautifying your home and yard, you can trust the professionals at Olson Wills Landscaping. Celebrating 10 years and featuring over 50 years of combined design-build experience, Olson Wills' superior workmanship has made us one of Wisconsin's premier landscaping firms. With our work showcased in the Parade of Homes, you can see for yourself the quality, professionalism, and pride we put into every job. Because your land deserves the very best, call Olson Wills Landscaping. Olson Wills Landscaping, serving all of Wisconsin.
If it's impressive,
it's Fearings. If it's high tech,
it's Fearings. If it makes you go, wow,
it's Fearings.
Every component of your AV project is handled from conception to completion by a Fearings professional.
From houses of worship to auditoriums, sports complexes, nightclubs, and sports bars, Fearings Electronic Systems is your pro AV solution.
Now celebrating our 10th year in business, we're Fearings Electronic Systems. Visit us online at fearings.com.
There's a new mutt in town, and he's about to spot his territory. You've been warned. Lazy Muck Farmhouse Ale is a craft-brewed wheat-style beer made in small batches in Monroe, Wisconsin. Lazy Muck, man's best friend.
I hope that every penny that they've spent on me, they know it was money well spent.
Welcome back to Farewell to Favre, NBC 15's hour-long special on the end of the Brett Favre era. On Thursday in Green Bay, Favre went before the world and looked into the cameras and said, I'm done. He said so much more, of course, and since, try as we might, no one can take us inside what his career was and what his future will be better than Favre himself, we now let him do just that in his own words.
Seems like just yesterday we were here. Well, I think we all know why I'm here. First of all, sorry I'm late, but I am officially retiring from the NFL and Green Bay Packers. And as much as I've thought about what I would say and how I promised I wouldn't get emotional. I thought about so many different things and how I wanted to say some of the things that I feel like I need to say. I'd like to thank the Packers for giving me an opportunity as well. I hope that every penny it was never about the money or fame or the records. It was never my accomplishments. It was our accomplishments and the teammates that I played with, and I can name so many. It was never about me. It was about everybody else. Just so happens that the position I played got most of the attention, and I hope that this organization and the fans appreciate me as much as I appreciate them. I know there's been comments and issues in the press lately about why I'm leaving, whether or not the Packers did enough, whether or not Ted and Mike tried to convince me to stay. None of those things have any thing to do with me retiring. And that's from the heart. I've given everything I possibly can give to this organization, to the game of football, and I don't think I got anything left to give, and that's it. I know I can play, but I don't think I want to. What matters is it's been a great career for me, and it's over. As hard as that is for me to say, it's over. I will wonder if I made the wrong decision, but I just don't think I can give anything else. Aside from the 3 hours on Sundays and in football, you can't do that. It's a total commitment. And up to this point, I have been totally committed. I've done everything there is to do, and then some, and then some. I gave it my all. I think people who know me know that. And I just don't know if I had any more to give. As I look back on my career, no regrets. No regrets whatsoever. Sure, I would have liked to have won more games. Would have liked to have gone to the Super Bowl this year.
Favre looks end zone.
Would have liked to have thrown less interceptions. More touchdowns, but no regrets. I played the game one way. The only way I knew how.
What are some of the things that you're looking forward to doing?
Nothing. Ron Wolf asked me yesterday, what are you going to do? I said, nothing. And I'm going to stick to that until I want to do something else. It will be nice for a while, I think, to not feel like I have to live up to certain expectations, not only that other people have of me, but that I have of myself. I can just kind of, as they say, ride off into the sunset, whatever that means, you know. Just try to relax for once in my life and enjoy it. I truly appreciate the opportunity. And as they say, all good things must come to an end.
Favre will now ride off into the sunset, knowing that he indeed was still near the top of his game, and the 2007 season produced more memorable moments, like number 5 on our list. in the dome known for home runs and that had been a house of horrors during his time with the Packers, Brett Favre hit for number 421, climbing to the top of the mountain.
It's a great day to break a very impressive record.
Everyone in the dome on their feet in anticipation of Brett Favre setting the all-time touchdown record.
I said, get out the way. I'm throwing it somewhere else, but get out the way.
We didn't think he was going to get the playoff.
I really thought that this would be a big play if we could get it off.
I knew it, he knew it, and it was just a matter of connecting.
Looking at the slant, he's got it! There it is! The record!
It felt great.
To be mentioned in the same breath as Dan and other guys is quite an honor. I mean, that, to me, that's more important than the actual record itself.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you, too. I want it in red because I want some fur. He's been buried alive.
Oh, she looks cute.
Yeah, honey. Oh, I'm hanging in there.
Get the Charter Bundle for only $99.97 per month for 12 months. Call 1-877-SAVE-909 today.
Excuse me. Hi.
Hi.
I've got 2 kids and an 8-hour drive. Give me a
room. How about a couple of DVD players?
So they can each watch their own DVD?
That would be great. Thank you.
The New Day special value packages are here.
Thank you.
Get Town & Country Signature Series with dual DVDs at no extra charge, plus remote start and a rear backup camera standard. Get great deals, plus $500 auto show bonus cash on Town & Country. It's a new day, Chrysler.
Batteries Plus is your one-stop source for anything that needs a battery. Boats and personal watercraft, motorcycles and scooters, ATVs, riding mowers. Plus, batteries for every other tool and toy you can think of. Remember, if it needs a battery, all you need is Batteries Plus, America's battery experts.
Visit one of our Madison East, West, or Janesville locations.
Hungry? Why not enjoy a delicious Italian meal and help support Meals on Wheels? Call Home Health United to order a $10 Benvenuto's meal certificate, then have your lunch delivered during the week of March 24. Or enjoy your meal at either Madison Benvenuto's location anytime during March. You'll help Madison, Middleton, and Monona residents receive a daily meal and wellness check in their homes. Satisfy your hunger and help your neighbor. Call Home Health United and order your Benvenuto's gift certificates today.
As I walk away, I'm walking away on top, my head high, chin up, and it is on my terms.
Going out on top, very few athletes can say they did it. And while Brett Favre's 2007 season did not end in a Super Bowl victory, no one can say number 4 didn't go out with a bang. In fact, the season went so well, it's what led many to believe Favre would come back in 08. Instead, it will go down as the last chapter in a page-turning career.
It was a surprise to all of us, especially since Favre proved at 38 years old he could still sling it with the best in the NFL. In week 2, Favre broke John Elway's record, picking up his 149th win as a quarterback. The touchdown total was the next to fall. But more important to Favre was Green Bay's 4-0 start. Old habits returned in week 5. This interception thrown right to Brian Urlacher played a part in the Pack's first loss of 07. But Green Bay quickly got back on the horse, winning 6 straight. Games which saw another Monday night miracle, Favre's first victory against the Chiefs, becoming just the 3rd quarterback to beat all 31 NFL franchises. And we all gave thanks as Favre set another Packer record, completing 20 straight passes in a Thanksgiving Day defeat of Detroit. Week 13 gave us a glimpse into the future. In a battle for NFC supremacy, Favre struggled before leaving the showdown in the Lone Star State with an elbow injury, paving the way for Aaron Rodgers to lead a near comeback victory. Favre exorcised his previous demons in St. Louis by providing the Hall of Fame with another piece of history.
Brett Favre has now passed for more yards in his career than any other quarterback in National Football League history.
Favre's final game against the rival Bears will be one he'd love to forget. The Windy City blew Green Bay away, Still, the Packers tied a franchise best with 13 wins. Favre would finish the season with a personal best, completing 66% of his passes while throwing almost twice as many touchdowns as interceptions. The NFC divisional game pitted Favre against two old friends in a picture-perfect playoff setting at Lambeau Field. Like the snow falling on the frozen tundra, the Pack piled it on the Seahawks, advancing to the NFC Championship, where temperatures would be frigid, seemingly the ideal condition for the king of cold weather. But the Hollywood ending to Favre's career wasn't meant to be. And little did we know, falling one game shy of the Super Bowl would be a determining factor in his decision to bid farewell.
Boy, we were right there. But that was last year.
Next fall, Football Sundays will certainly take on a much different look and feel for Favre and the Packers. Still to come, we'll look back on some of the plays and moments you may have forgotten about, such as carving up the defending Super Bowl champion Ravens. You're watching NBC 15's presentation of Farewell to Favre, the end of an era.
As energy costs continue to rise, low-income families and the elderly are the first to suffer. In Dane and Greene counties, Project Home's weatherization program can save you on energy costs dramatically. It lowers your energy consumption, increases your comfort, and makes it more affordable for you to remain in your home. So if you want to beat the cold this winter, contact Project Home at 608-246-3737 or find more information at projecthomewi.org. Project Home will keep you warm with the ones you love.
Movement. It's as simple as a walk in the park. Multiple sclerosis stops people from moving. Walk MS raises money to fund cutting-edge research and provides programs and services to help people with MS and their families move their lives forward.
Join us for Walk MS, presented by Christopher and Banks, May 4th. Visit wismsorg or call 800-FIGHT-MS. Join the movement.
Every child deserves a loving family. You can make the difference. Right now, FamilyWorks is looking for the right people to open their hearts and homes to mentor foster children of all ages. Become a treatment foster family today and earn more than $1,300 a month. If you can provide a child with stability, support, and love, call FamilyWorks at 233-9204. That's 233-9204.
At CARICOM, we believe that I is the most insignificant word in the English language. Here, we work with you to help select the best phone for your needs.
That's a we, which rhymes with V, for Voyager, Venus, and Verizon Wireless.
CARICOM is Madison's own Verizon Wireless authorized premium retailer.
So if you've been in a store where all they talk about is I, step up to CARICOM experience, where we is all that matters.
I can recite almost every play I've ever ran, called.
He may remember every play, but over the years, we've relived many of the same iconic moments over and over again. And yet, there are still countless lesser-known plays and performances that Favre's mind and body produce, each one building a block for a legendary career.
Favre's gonna throw it.
Driver's going to have his arms under the ball. He doesn't have control there, but now he cradles that ball in. That ball never touches the ground. They needed to make a big play. Look at Brett Favre there. That's the guy making the play for him.
That's a
even though you play hard against them, even the opponents love this guy.
Many of those moments and plays led not only to cheers and adulation from fans, but the respect of his peers, including opponents, who all realized that playing with and against Brett Favre was something special.
Discover a refuge in your own backyard. The knowledgeable staff at Wild Birds Unlimited will show you a selection of gifts, garden accents, and unique products that will help you enjoy nature every day. Wild Birds Unlimited on Old Sauk Road in Middleton. We bring people and nature together.
Sculpt your body, remake your shape, and become the new you. Enjoy a life full of self-confidence and assurance, free of physical frustrations and imperfections. The team of board-certified plastic surgeons and estheticians at the Mercy Regional Plastic Surgery Skin and Laser Center can help. We have the experience and personal touch to help you every step of the way. Do something for yourself. You deserve it. It's time to sculpt your body, remake your shape, and become the new you. Take the first step with the team at the Mercy Regional Plastic Surgery Skin and Laser Center in Janesville and Lake Geneva.
The right ones with the good stuff.
Got a tough job? Check out the line of New Holland Super Boom skid steers from Carleff Stotts & Sons. Contractors, landscapers, farmers, there's a Super Boom that fits the need. With the most attachments, unbeatable performance, and legendary reliability, New Holland Super Boom skid steers get the job done. See Carleff Stotts & Sons, Highway 19, Waikiki. New Holland Super Boom skid steers. Any job, anytime, anywhere.
Now is the time. Here is the place. And this is the truck. Chevy Silverado Halftime. The full-size pickup available with best-in-class 4x4 fuel economy. Well-qualified buyers, get yours with 0% APR financing for 60 months. Shop Chevy now. Visit us online at ChevyDrivesBadgers.com.
Right now at Lakeland, get this fiberglass truck cap in your choice of color for only $7.99. Or this fiberglass hardcover in your choice of color, now just $6.59. But hurry, these prices are only available for a very limited time. Lakeland in Greenbush, Madison, Green Bay, and Oak Creek.
I'm going to steal a quote from Deanna. When she said, now I thought about this on the way up, see life through the front windshield, not through the rearview mirror. There's some things I missed. And hopefully, I mean, you can't get those things back, but from this day forward, I hope to kind of see things through the front windshield.
Welcome back to NBC 15's presentation of Farewell to Favre, the end of an era. Before this show is retired, we want to remind you to log on to our web channel, NBC15.com, and vote for your favorite memory of Brett Favre's career. The results of our poll will be revealed tomorrow night on Wisconsin Sports Sunday. But first, one last look back at the moments and the career that returned the NFL's most storied franchise to the glory on the field. On behalf of the NBC 15 sports team, our producer Sam Sorensen, and our entire crew, thanks for watching NBC 15's Farewell to Favre, the end of an era. And thanks for the memories, Brett. Good night.
At first, I was a little shocked and thought that, you know, they're going to send me up there to be a backup in Green Bay. But, you know, after talking to the owner and the head coach there today, they want me to come in and start. And it's up to me on whether or not, you know, I become a starter. So, hey, you know, I can't ask for more.
There's never a win better than when you only got 100 years to live.
On a quick snap, second down. With daylight and time, goes for the whole thing. Touchdown! Green Bay leads. Brett Favre.
Would you see I'm there? Kid on the way.
to live. Half the time goes by. Suddenly your eyes are no the blink of an eye. 67 is gone. The sun is getting high. We're moving around.
Fred waits for the snap. Goes straight back in the pocket. Okay. He's got to get rid of the ball. He got rid of it. He throws it wide open.
A 100 years to live.